and welcome to Kafeero.tv. My name is Angela Samoger, your host for tonight, and today we are hosting the lovely Bella Wine CEO, Miss Prudence Ukkonika. Nice to have you here today, Prudence.
Thank you very much. Thank you for hosting me.
Okay, so we're very interested in getting to know who Prudence is and how you came to build this household name, Bella Wine. Was it something you always thought of doing as a child, maybe in your university? Can we say something that you aspired to do, or was it something that just came as life went on?
Okay, I'm Mrs. Prudence Ukkonika. The CEO, as you have introduced, Angela, of Bella Wine. Bella Wine is a natural drinks. When I say natural, I mean they are organic from our natural fruits. And the fruits are also organic. We don't use any chemicals, and we don't use fruits which have been sprayed.
Oh, okay.
That is the uniqueness of Bella Wine and Bella Juice.
Oh, that's the selling point.
Yes. Okay. We are located in Wandegeya at Moro Petrol Station between YMCA and the Wandegeya Police. But our factory is in Chirana Mugongo.
Okay.
Yes.
So should we say, was it a dream of yours as a child to start Bella Wine? Were you interested in getting into the wine business? Let's say as you were studying, what was on your mind? Did you know that at some point you'd be the successful businesswoman that you are?
No. But when I look back, I see how I used to pray as a child.
Right.
I used to pray things as if I'm doing business.
Oh.
For example, you find that you go to the shop, to the tailor, I pick those clothes they cut. Then I put a rope, I put a shelter like a house. Then I start selling different materials.
Wow. So that entrepreneurial spirit really was from childhood.
It was from childhood. When I look back what I did as I grew up.
Oh, that's very interesting. So we can say it was always on your mind to be a businesswoman.
Yeah, I've been with Ministry of Finance for the last 34 years. I'm just retiring, but I've never settled in office. Nobody does my office work, but every time I have something I'm selling.
Okay, that's very interesting. And can you tell us exactly how Bella Wine started? Because you talk about the stores in Wandegeya or the factory. It didn't always start like that, I'm sure. Where did you begin?
Angela, it is a very long story. If I'm to tell you, maybe we need 2 days here. But I can cut it short.
Please do.
I'd never thought of being involved in such, though I'm from a family. My family of brewers. My father used to brew local brew. Then it was not enough because he started with the juice. You know how to make this juice from matoke.
Yes, yes, Mobisi, is
it? Mobisi. Yes. Then he went to Tonto. And now people realize that there is business in matoke. So everyone now started this. What? Selling to him.
Okay.
Previously, they were just making and drinking. But now they realize there is money. So it was too much and he wanted to help them. So he started transporting it all around Kigezi. Starting from a bicycle. A bicycle until he bought a car, and now he had to add value in that Tonto.
Yes.
So he made the warag. He was among the first people who got the license. But I never thought I would do that business.
Yes.
That is a business that educated us, but I never thought of doing it.
So does that mean, did you pay any attention to detail? Because I know there are young people who actually just know, oh, my mother works in finance, or my father works in this place, but if you get down to the nitty-gritty and you ask them, what does your mother do in finance? They actually have no idea. But can we say, did you pay any keen attention?
For example, very much. We were participating in everything.
Oh, okay.
Because, now making that waragi or running a bar.
Yes.
We are the ones who were sailing in the bar.
Okay.
Like weekends, after classes. People thought even we were going to be spoiled by
the work that you were doing.
By working in a bar. But now those innocent girls who were there, the ones who used to come on Sunday, they just give him one cut thought and she gets drunk, gets excited. Mm. But so for us, we see people misbehaving. You don't want to be like them.
Oh, that's an interesting aspect of things.
Yes. Wow. So even if those who, the teachers who used to take on credit, where they used to supply the tonton credit, my father taught me how to ride a bicycle so that I go and collect the debts before I go to school.
Wow.
And my brothers also used to help during holidays. They take the stuff to town, like Kavale, where. So we grew up doing the business.
Okay. Wow, that's very good. And so that takes me back to the question. So you decide, let me start Bella Wine. Was it a transition from something? I need to get to that point where you're like, now we're going to use hibiscus or the fruit to make wine. Because if you talk about your history, it had to do with Tonto and Warajo. What made you decide to go the direction of wine rather than maybe Waraji or Tonto? Why wine?
Okay, let me be a bit brief. It was my brother-in-law's graduation party. The two daughters were graduating, which is a very big achievement for a parent.
Yes.
And he invited very many people, including some relatives from the village. Mm-hmm. So one of our their neighbors, who is also a relative, decided to bring local wine.
Okay.
And one of my sons was among those who were serving.
Mm.
He was also an entrepreneur, and again, also maybe a researcher, I don't know. Because after that, he told me what I have realized. People have enjoyed, because this is the minister's home.
Yes.
Who had very many imported wines.
Mm-hmm.
But this wine which came from the village, people were enjoying it more than the local, the imported wines.
Okay.
Then he said, he was at Mobs.
Mm.
He said, I'm going to what? To start now ordering it, selling it around.
Yes.
The uncles helped him. They started sending it to him. We had a Land Cruiser.
Mm-hmm.
From classes, he would move around with his friends at Mobs. Selling. So I also used to help him taking it to finance.
Mm.
And he kept on saying, this business, I see future in it.
Okay.
But unfortunately, as he was, the cousins had invited him in the UK to go and do some modeling during the work.
Mm.
Because he was, the way you see me, but for him, he had beat his body.
Okay.
Unfortunately, as he was trying to get a visa, he collapsed that evening. He passed away. And you know, now as a parent, and we're very close, my life changed, the life of the family changed. I also tried to run away from Uganda. I say I can't stand it now. But my children say now, was it the only child? We have lost a brother, now we're also running away. But I have lost so much weight. Again, I asked myself, which way will I get a visa without going through the... Because he was trying to get a visa when he collapsed and died that same day.
Mm.
How will I get a visa without going through the same...
Yes, predicament.
Yes. So I knelt down and prayed to God, show me a way I can survive without going abroad. Because the whole family lost interest in everything.
Mm.
Water was cut off, power was cut off.
Everything went downhill.
Like seeing your son going with a jerrycan to go to the well to get water.
Wow.
So I said no. When I prayed, that's when I got that message, when he was saying, Mommy, I see future in this business.
Mm.
Then I got up and continued with the same business.
Wow.
But it picked so much that the man who was just doing it as a hobby at home was surprised by the market I made. I started getting wine which is not ready.
Mm-hmm.
I said, no, I have to, this is something which people are consuming. I have to know the source. So I had to go back at school. I paid some private teachers. I got a kind professor in Chambogo. Then I also got technical people.
Wow.
We started making our own. And the market was overwhelming.
Wow.
So that's how I started. I started now selling to relatives,
yes,
family members, then to neighbors, to workmates. Now somebody would buy it from me, he's in the cover, he calls me, please put it on the bus, I said no. With my other son who follows him. We say we have to see how we can make this wine spread.
Yes.
And the only way was to put it in a bottle like this. Yes. Because I was selling in jerry cans and plastic bottles.
Yes. I was actually going to ask, when did you reach the branding part? Because at that point, I'm sure, like you said, put it on the bus and jerry cans.
And any when somebody challenges you, yes. Don't get annoyed. He's pushing you to another step.
Another level, yes.
Or another level. Mm. Because I used to think I go picking these plastic bottles. I could not go to these industries and tell them, you make my special bottle.
Yes.
I have to make a bottle maybe which the one packing Quencher is using. They think I pick the other one of Quencher.
Yes.
It was annoying, but I said this has to stop. So that's when we made a lot of research how we can pack and compete with
the rest of the market.
The imported wines and how we can supply it everywhere.
Yes.
You cannot put plastic bottles in the supermarkets.
Yes. Not if you're competing with other.
So we did a lot of research to see how we can come up with a bottle like this. But eventually we succeeded. Yeah, it is.
So I've heard a lot of we. At this point, who were you working with when you say
all
we?
All the family members.
All the family members.
All the family members. They were still at school. They were young.
Wow.
But they all showed interest.
So basically, the working ethic has been instilled in the family right from a young age. We start with you,
yes.
Being working during your father's time, and even your children working. Which I think is something that doesn't happen a lot today.
Yeah, it doesn't happen. And the mistake I've seen people doing is to bring in their children when they are big.
Yeah. Oh, that's a good point.
Yeah, you want to change the... Because a child is the... They say they are formed at 8 years.
Wow.
So you cannot change somebody. Like in this one, all these were in Kafeero TV.
Yeah.
If their fathers have business, they cannot come and say, join my business.
Mm.
Because now they have been used to other, or showed interest in IT.
Mm.
You cannot say, come and do join my business, wherever, whichever business you are doing.
Mm.
But from childhood, I saw how they had different interests.
Yes.
You could say, you come and cut passion fruits,
mm-hmm.
You say no. He was interested in seeing how many has come, how much is it, what. Then the one who are saying, you come and calculate for me because they have brought these things, say, no, let me first cut this.
Yes.
Now, today, the one who was interested in the cutting is the one who is heading production.
Mm.
The one who was calculating is the one who is an accountant, your accountant.
Wow. So basically you identified their skills from a young age and placed them in the right place.
Yes.
And there was no, because I'm getting to the point where, or what I see is some parents will be like, gun cut the passion fruit, and the child doesn't want to, but you insist. So they end up actually hating the role.
Yes.
Oh,
but now, after identifying what one wants, that's where you push him more. And you see he's doing it without any force. He's doing it with passion.
Right.
Yeah.
So your children, I'm sure, you didn't mention how many children you have?
I had 6.
Okay.
Yeah, the first one, when she also was doing her master's,
yes.
She also studied a bit of wine. She came with a lot of literature about wine.
Wow.
That is our consultant.
Okay.
She's still working in other organizations, but she comes and plans and goes back.
Okay.
Then the another one is the accountant.
Mm.
That one, I had to go back at school when he reached the A-level. I went and studied with him A-level.
Wow.
We all did the business administration at the move. He went to Mubs, I went to Ndeji.
Oh.
Yeah.
So each one was studying and bringing back results and checking, have you done your homework? and making sure that everyone's making sure they're passing their exams.
The only mistake I wanted to do, you know me, ours was like private. It was A level for adults. So for them, they did their mock during the day.
Yes.
We did our mock in the evening.
Oh.
So I said, I called him and I went to him, can you give me those papers? I said, mommy, do you want to cheat? I got embarrassed.
Because you felt, okay, I'm the parent and I'm the one requesting.
Showing a bad example.
Oh, but that's interesting that you should get the business. Because I think if your family is involved, the legacy stands a chance because it's down from the heart.
Yeah, all my children are involved. Okay. Even the vehicles are being taken care of. The one who took mechanical engineering, also does some marketing.
Now, when we look at the wine itself, you'd use different fruits.
Yes.
Passion fruit, pineapple. For us who don't understand how wine is made, do you have to pick specific fruit? Because I know that hibiscus is your core, is the core fruit.
Yes.
Why hibiscus? Because I got to know about hibiscus quite late in life. I don't know if it's something that's always been around, but I can say I was introduced to it maybe 3 years ago.
Yeah.
Has it always been there? And why did you choose hibiscus as your main plant of choice or my main fruit of choice?
Okay, I started with the passion fruits.
Okay.
It is people who give you ideas.
Mm-hmm.
So I made a sweet wine.
Right.
Then others kept saying, can't you make us a white, dry wine?
Yes.
We made our research with the my children, and we found out that we can make wine from pineapple.
Okay.
I made a wine from pineapple. Then one time as I was, excuse me, I was reading, it was a new vision. I saw an article that medicinal wine from Marakwang.
Wow.
Marakwang, I come from, I'm married to a northerner.
Okay.
So I've been going there. Marakwang is
like
a vegetable, what? But it has a lot of health benefits.
Okay.
When we did our research, we discovered that they meant hibiscus.
Mm.
Yeah, because that Marakwang, the leaves are eaten, but you cannot eat these leaves of this hibiscus.
Okay. Yes.
So I got very much interested. We made our research. That's when we made this the hibiscus wine. And it was interesting. It started helping people who have high blood pressure, diabetes.
Wow.
Yeah, that's why the brand is...
It's very popular.
Is more popular than others. Then also... I have altar wine. I think he didn't bring it from mangoes.
Oh.
I was at a religious function near here, and the bishops were teasing me, why can't you make us altar wine? I said, how should it taste?
Yes.
And we tried different foods. We came up with mangoes and tangerine.
Mm.
We make altar wine. It is very smooth, and they told me they wanted dry, but religious people use altar wine, which is recommended. By Porchua, you can't just give them any altar wine. But they use it as a table wine.
Yes.
Mm. Or when you have a function, you put a bottle of altar wine in front of a religious person.
Mm.
People don't eye him so much like any other drink. And also, this one is the tamariro. Tamariro is also from one of the fruits. It's common in the Western Uganda. People were growing it, but they didn't have... market.
Okay.
Supermarkets were buying it at a very low price, selling it here, and it was not going. But now I have helped them, they don't even have enough.
Okay.
So I've started sourcing from Rwanda. And also, since wine comes from grapes, I also had to make one from grapes.
Yes.
But I've challenged the whole world. You have been to Italy, I've been to France, I've been to South Africa, they know wine comes from only grapes.
Yes.
But I have made from wine, from almost every fruit.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're going to go for a short break. Please stay tuned. We'll be back in a few minutes.
We've just launched one of our biggest projects at Kafeero Foundation, which we believe that it's going to transform Africa. And this project is called Ujamaa. Ujamaa comes from a community. It was inspired by former president of Tanzania, Nyerere, and we wanted to keep his spirit alive within the new generation. And this was a product of community where he wanted to see that the community can work together. So under Ujamaa, our target is to reach 2 million Africans, young Africans who can be able to come under one community, and they're able to create businesses together. They're able to invest within each other, and through that project we are able to also create patient capital which can go to small startups, and they can be able to showcase their businesses and also crowdfund within the community. It's going to be a community of business, a community of knowledge, a community of education, and a community of sharing. We believe that we are creating the next generation of angel investors. So we believe that the whole community will be able to collaborate together in terms of resources and in terms of ideas. We are extremely excited as a foundation to come up with such a model.
Welcome back to Kafeero.tv. Once again, my name is Angela Mirembe, your host for today, and we have the lovely Prudence Ukkonika here, the CEO of Bella Wine. Thank you for what you shared in our previous session. Now, I want us to talk about work ethics and business in regards to young people. What mistakes do you see young people make today when it comes to starting a business or coming to work? Leaving university and coming in employment, what hindrances do you see they're putting before themselves and success?
Thank you, Angela, for that question. I thought you were going to leave it out, because most people think it is money which makes business.
Yes.
And it's very common with the younger people. You heard them fighting for this money for the youth. Is it what for the youth? Funds for the youth.
Yes.
You cannot, you are a user, you cannot start business from above. I can give you example, people who have looked after people's children.
Yes.
Maybe so a child has lost parents and you take over.
Yes.
You cannot understand that child. But your own child, you carried in your womb, brought up,
yes,
is very easy to understand. And the business is also like that. Business is like life. You don't just start from anywhere. Okay, you may have that chance of starting from anywhere, but to assure you, a successful business is that one which you have started
from the bottom.
Yes. I've seen very many people have run away from the country, have even tried almost committing suicide because of the mistakes they have made. Maybe they have rich people who can help them get... They have popular people who can get them some money, funds from somewhere, and that money is to be paid back. There's nobody giving you free money. Now you start from up, make a lot of mistakes, and you can't pay that money back. I always give example. If you start raw, let me say it is like a small restaurant, you start with a tray of eggs. If you make a mistake, maybe you have fried one or two eggs, you have realized the mistake.
Wow.
That money you can recover.
Yes.
But imagine you have
invested 10 million.
10 million eggs for the restaurant you put there. Then maybe you bought a wrong type. What will happen? You cannot tell the owner of the money that I'm sorry, I made this mistake.
Yes.
But if you start from there, you have bought 2-3 eggs. Yes. Maybe that is not a type which should be boiled. Maybe that is not a type which should be fried. You have learned from there.
Yes.
But, and what the young people, most of them, think money is easy to generate.
Yes.
It's not. Even I've seen people say, that woman has made money from wine.
Yes.
They even steal some of my workers.
You see, so somebody said, that money.
Can you imagine that boy who disappeared? Is with it? I said, no, leave them. Mm. Do you know there is this woman? I think this woman knows you. She's there selling wine. I said, no, mind your own business.
That's a very good
And I always tell people, if you want to progress, mind your own business. They say competition is very healthy.
Yes.
But I mean, I don't compete.
You know your brand.
I don't waste time going to see what somebody is doing. Unless I'm going for a new ideas.
Yes.
But I concentrate to do your research on how you can make yours better. Yes. Instead of going to fight the one who has also tried to make wine. I feel very happy. I was the first one. And I feel very happy people trying to come. People think somebody has started a wine, now I'm going to say a competition.
Yes.
No. I even go up to them, help them. I say, you don't know what you are doing.
Wow.
There is one who challenged me that, we shall also reach. I say, no, you will not reach. Since you cannot even listen to me, this is a mistake you have made. I'm trying to point it out. You said, we shall reach where you have reached.
Wow.
So you concentrate on your own. Do research about your own.
Find a way to improve it.
To improve, so that you grow.
Yes.
Slowly. But starting up with all those mistakes, that's the worst mistake I have seen.
No.
With the young people. Even old people. He has retired, they have paid him pension.
Yes.
He said, I think there is money in this business. Somebody has achieved, doesn't know that somebody struggled. Like this Kafeero TV, eventually it is going to be one of the biggest TV.
We believe that.
And it's busy. You know, this he started very slowly in Mwenga there. Now you see he's big. I think it is easy. With the parents, they should involve their children when they are young.
Yes.
And they shouldn't force them to do what they don't want to do.
Right.
Because like now, when you have noticed some children, you sit like this, they come straight to the phone.
Yes.
You can see his interest.
It's technology, so you shouldn't say, no, don't touch it.
He will spoil it eventually, but you know where that's where the interest is.
Lies.
Now that when you take him in agriculture, you are just wasting your time.
That's very true. That's very true. Okay, I think we'll take some questions from the audience. Do we have anyone?
Thank you for giving us your time. My name is Daniel. I had a few questions for you. I hope they are not too many. One of the things I wanted to ask was, number one, when you were coming up, did you have any mentors? Because a lot of times when we listen to business people, they always say, you need a mentor, you need someone to guide you, someone who has been there. Just like you said, when someone wanted to enter wine, you pointed out their mistakes.
Yes.
That is the first question.
You said when I was growing up.
Coming up in
the business. Of course, that's why I had to go to technical people, like a professor in food science in Chambogo. He was very helpful. I also went to Nogamo. I wanted to make a special wine, which is organic. Nogamo is just your neighbor here. They did in the organic products, Nogamo.
Okay.
By the way, I started buying fruits from them. They were buying, getting fruits from organic farmers, and I would buy from them. When my business grew, I said, no, we will not make money when you buy from us, so let us connect you directly to the farmers.
Okay.
And they also gave me some people who can help me in making organic wine. So I got involved, I became a member of Nogamo. I went to Kulika. Kulika also had some of those things I could use when you are starting wine. And of course, they also gave me some technical people who can help me. It is also in Zambia. Yeah. Nogamo was in Zambia trading center, but now it is here, just your neighbor up here. Another question?
Thank you for that. The other question, the last question I've been told, would be for young people. You can see a lot of us who are in the audience.
Yes.
And I think you can, as a parent, get your ages. What would you suggest to young people who are starting out or who are interested in starting out in business? What businesses do you see they can invest in what opportunities are there? If you are a young person, what opportunities would you put your money and time into?
Each one of us, you have something where you have interest. You see me, I didn't have this nice lipstick. There is a lady who has just put it for me. Why of all people did she all of us are gifted in one way or another. Just listen to yourself. Where do you have much interest? If you are to do business, that's what you should do. I would advise, like, this girl tomorrow wants to start a business. Let her start a small salon. She has a kit, she has everything. She can even use that to build up her business. Because most people think you cannot do business without capital. I did, and I'm a very good example. And even last time I was telling them, you have to be a God-fearing person. Don't think you will build money through cheating, telling lies. These days you have these phones. You have taken somebody's money. You say, I'm sorry, I'm stuck in the jam. I cannot bring this money, but tomorrow the phone is off. You have changed the number. How far will you go?
My name is Derek, and my question is there like an institution right now that someone can go to or come to you to learn about wines? If, let's say, I want to, I don't know, become a wine tester or know more about wine or even how to make it, how to make the wine itself. Is there somewhere in Uganda I can study that?
You see, Derek, thanks for that question. There is no specific place where you can go and study wine. But wine is like food. It is not like these mechanics who just start as spanner boys, then become mechanics. See, they cannot be proper mechanics. So I cannot say you can come to me and I teach you. But if you go to like these people in food science, they have the methods how you can start. And we have also Uganda Industrial Research. Uganda Industrial Research, if you are very patient, you can learn from them. They can even give you space. You bring your fruits. They have certain demands, they do that. Then from there, we can also help you. But I can't start with you. It needs the people who are specialized in doing that. Okay.
I have a second question. Apart from wine, is there another business you're dealing in?
Me, I came to realize I'm a business person, a business woman, because I have never been there without doing business. I don't know how to depend on someone. Even my own parents, my father was very proud of me because when I went to secondary school, I used to bring back the capital, the pocket money he was giving me. They were giving us breakfast, lunch, and supper. But there are these people who come to say, you know, what you take at school is not enough. They give you porridge without escort. So there are these people who used to sell outside the gate, and they were allowed to buy. There was a lady who had very nice cakes. So I would tell her, now, instead of wasting time here, you have to go back and dig. What you do, count your cakes? Tell me how many you are leaving for me, in the evening come back for money. Within a short time, they said, there's nothing says like a hot cake. I would move around and the basket is empty. I give her, I've eaten free cakes. Now why should I bother with my father's money? When I came to Kampala, I went to MOBS. It was the Nakawa College of Commerce. He would give me pocket money. One day, we had only one bus, which was leaving at night. So when my father gave me, there is transport, there is pocket money, there is tuition, I'm coming to Kampala from Rukunjiri. Yet, I had realized there are no second-hand clothes here. Yet, there are shops around our place and the clothes are cheap. So I put all the money, I only remained with transport. Unfortunately, the bus did not come. And unfortunately, my father also cannot just leave money hanging there. Because we have to wait for the following day. Now when he, in the morning, came say, you people didn't go, no. okay, give me that money. Because he can go and buy Tonto. He takes to the bar. They sell and the money, he gets profit. I say, I'm sorry, I don't have. He got so much disappointed. He said, I didn't know you were doing prostitution in Kampala. But inside me, I knew what I have done. And I knew God knows what I have done. He stopped there. I never asked him for more tuition. When I bought those clothes, I went to Ruzira market. The first trade I went to, bought everything. Now I have almost doubled the what? Then in that same market, I saw groundnuts. If I fry these groundnuts, this ship which goes to Seis Island, they go with nothing. Either you eat before you go, or you eat when you reach. So I collaborated with the people who were working in the ship. I got some papers, I fried, I gave them. They took. Now when I told they were coming back, I said, don't come, don't bring me money. Seis Island, the pineapples are very cheap. They bring pineapples, I take to Nakawa market. So that's how I was, By the time you realize, I have enough money. I don't even need his pocket money. Once you fear God, there is, when you do something hiding, you know you are with the devil. And that devil will take you nowhere. When people say you are great, what? No, I'm nothing. Just because when you fear God, he can take you anywhere. I can stand here with the present, people will choose me. I'm not saying it is what, but it can be possible. Yeah, but I think we're out of the way.
I had a question, and you are like, we should start from the bottom.
Yes.
Now, what advice do you give to the youth who are being offered loans? Should they just drop them and look for other means, or they should take up the loans and take on the risks?
That's a very hard question, a very big, very hard advice. Those who are rushing for that money, you have not started anything. Why do you think you can do business after getting that money? Don't think most of them who are rushing for that money have intention of doing business. That money is not very easy to get. Because like me, people say, well, there is money in the private sector, there is money in the president's office. I have never gone anywhere. I'm not a beggar. I've built my business on my own. Why should I go out and beg? That child who has not done anything, because even when I was school, I was doing business. If you have not done anything, that money will do nothing to you. It is better you leave it. Because you are going to enjoy it. And they stop there. You have seen even people who have started business. They have reached somewhere. They want to show off. RAV4. What? You don't work to show the world. I started without any transport. I used to take my wine in the bag, in the caveras, in what? Until I saw these Indians. You go to, when I started now, taking to supermarkets. There is a way when in their supermarkets they have. There is a way they see how somebody has come in their parking.
Wow.
If they don't have, they will go. When you say, I have this, there is a way you will go out and see there is no car parked there. Say, this wine is. These days they are fake wines, what? So what I say, I'm not going to go far. I just went to coin. I didn't want any middle person. I went to the Indian who's selling the vehicles there. I said, I want a car and I don't have any money. He thought I was joking. He said, no, okay, you bring 80%. I said, I don't have any money, but I have business. He said, okay, bring 50%. I stayed there the whole day. I went. The following day, I came back until he got tired. He asked a fellow Indian, is the other person still there? Let her try it. I couldn't believe he gave me that pajama. I said, I'm going to pay you as I work.
Wow. So you basically got it with no money?
With no money at all. I said, I have checks. I can what? I can supply, I can write postdated checks. Because people are not trusted.
Yes.
So whatever you would sell, because now after putting the one in a Pajero,
yes.
these other Indians who are saying, they say, huh? How much is it? It gets his calculator. Okay, consignment. Because I mean, he's not going to give you cash. I said, it's okay. I put it there. Those big supermarkets, I get a girl, she will go there, taste the wine, is what they start buying. And whatever I said, I go and pay for the installment. Remove one check, two checks. The Indian was overwhelmed. By the time he realized I had finished paying. In fact, they say the rich also cry. When I was remaining with the 2 million, he called me. He said, Prudence, do you have 1 million? I said, yes. You bring the, I give you your logbook. I took it to him. Now the logbook is in my name. I went straight to Fauru, who could not give me a loan without security. Now this is security in my name. Because I would want to take my husband's car, but with my car, what? But this is mine now. I took it there and they gave me more money. And they give me money now. Because now business, wine is now moving, I inject it in my money, in the business. And that's how the business started expanding. Now I drove that Pajero for years. But now you are so mean. This Pajero, no. They would tell my children, tell your mommy to buy another car. Why do you have to be told? I know my income. Like right now, my objective is to be an international brand. Yes. You cannot say, there are very nice cars in Japan. That one, you just put your name, Bera. Show the world. But if I don't do that, in 2 years, I'm going to be an international. I've been to very many countries already. There is a sign, they like my wine. But it needs to put in a road. Why should I go for that luxurious? To show you that I have made it, I put right there, Bera.
What the young people want, you know, they know when you drive.
Stop showing off. Be who you are. Yeah, you want, you see, I wish I show you my phone. There's time I left it somewhere. They got it, but they couldn't expect it was mine. I was looking for my phone, they have it. They thought they might have these phones, like maybe the what she's carrying. You want to impress girlfriends? Those girlfriends are just maybe going to kill you for nothing. You try to grow up decently. They say good things. When you go to a buffet, some of you make a mistake. You start serving, heaping the plate. Come the chicken, the ruombo is ahead there. You start, by the time you reach the ruombo,
the plate is
full. Yes. So you be patient, go slow. Work for yourself, don't show anyone. For what? Just fear God, show God what you are doing. He will. They are not stupid. Even if you get a job of 200, God knows my child is earning 200. He has to eat. He has to pay rent. You will manage. But I want to also take this opportunity. Don't be shy to make clean money and rush to take dirty money. I was working with the Minister of Finance. I started working for 4,000. But that's where I even met my husband. We have a difference of 10 years. He wanted the children. So we started producing almost every year. But we are all civil servants. But we had to make sure my children also survives. I don't want to be malnourished. What? Yes. Now what I did, like now there is season of tangerine. You see women carrying in the baskets, wheelbarrows, pickups. But your child cannot eat, you cannot afford. As a civil servant, you can't afford that. So I will see the fruit which is in the season. During break time at the finance, I just go to Nakasero. I get they sell them in these big baskets. I get a basket, put it on a wheelbarrow. I pass in a Kafeero shops, I buy Kaveras, I go behind the blocks, I put, now these accountants who are there stealing money, they don't have time to go for shopping. They go to supermarkets, oranges are too expensive. So oranges which would buy like 10,000, I'm giving him at 5,000, and to his desk, why can't he put that 5,000 for me? Then there is a middle class, maybe oranges which would buy like 5,000, that one is getting it at 1,000. Then I come to my level. Those ones I gave Kaveero at 5,000. my man has already come. Yeah. Then the remaining, I also fill a basket on a dining table. My children eat. Yeah. My man is back. Yeah. Wow. So that's how, when I see somebody saying I don't have money, I just get surprised. When I see young boys running on the street, job, 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 in this Kampala where there is too much money. I've even tried to help some people. Okay, you come to me, I've made this product for you. You say you know how to sell. You go sell, bring back my money. There is a boy who was going to parliament where he was selling shirts, second-hand shirts. But the difference is like 1,000, 2,000. You enter in parliament. What? They will buy this wine. So the boy started selling his shirts and he's also selling this. When he reached on 6 bottles, he came when I was not there. I think he broke on the one to show that some piece that is broken. He disappeared. Now imagine, you can imagine if that boy had continued, he would be having his own store somewhere with the wine. When you don't have capital, you are trusted. You know how to market. Do you need to first make your own product? You come to me and you take one carton, you have sold it. Let me give you an example. I used the when before I even got married, we were working half day. We were working in shifts. My cousin was a nurse in a Zambia hospital. So after work, I can't just go home. I would go on Romo Street. This Nubian, I go to a wholesale shop. I see T-shirts. I ask the Nubians, he said, these T-shirts, how much a dozen? Can you please sell me one T-shirt? I said, I'm coming back to buy wholesale, but he helped me because they want to sell wholesale. He gives me the T-shirt. I pass like 3 shops. I have these T-shirts, how much? If he's giving me 10,000, I say 12. You go to another. They don't know each other. Each one minds his own business. They don't know these T-shirts are here. After like now, when he says bring a dozen, I rush back. I say give me this dozen. I'm bringing the money. I take the what? He pays me. I bring the money. Then I get another 2 dozen. It's like that. Then one time my colleague was saying, but every day borrowing transport for me. I said, come on, we go. We did the same. She was very happy. You go to these like Channel Street, there are these women who sew. They sew baby dresses. You don't have much money. I buy a dozen. You come and say to people with dress with 2,000, what? People buy, my money's back. When you go to Romo Street, the dresses are there very cheap in the dozens. Must say I did not yet come by then to stop hawkers. I get my son, I just go and buy dozens of dresses. I go to these officers. Within a short time, it is finished. I go to a place like Fishnet. I convince the manager, the one in charge of this. Okay, accounts.
Okay.
So, beginning of the month, I give them what they want: dresses for their children, theirs. End of the month, I'm there. From account section, get your salary, pass by my car, pay. Wow. I would call my cousins to escort me because I'm going to bring a bag of money. When I'm pregnant, I did nappies. By the time I deliver, I have enough nappies for my baby. There were no pampers.
Yes.
Christmas, I did clothes. Let me say I have boys and girls. Those are the clothes, the sizes I will did in. I'm selling and getting what?
Wow.
So my children were ever smart.
I think we feel embarrassed and ashamed.
The most important thing, be trustworthy. If you do you need, even Musisi, it may not get you. You see all these people. If you bring a very nice a dozen of t-shirts like this, will they not buy? They will. Do you need rent?
I think that's those are very key words, because what we hear is the song, unemployment, unemployment, find us jobs.
It is here, not employment. And people think stealing. When you steal, you are, they are cursing yourself. This is one of my drivers. He's a very trusted boy. Yes? I don't associate with thieves. And if you steal from me and I keep quiet, that is the worst. But if I take you to police, they give you small chibok, the punishment ends there. But there is nobody who has cheated me and has succeeded. So cheating, stealing is useless. You will not even get that wisdom of doing anything. It is even like cheating. Because I had to add value to myself to see how I can convince customers, to how to manage my business. Because when I went did A level with my son, he took accounting, I took management, I managed my business. So, where are we?
We're talking about being trustworthy and cheating and adding value to yourself so that you can possibly go on the right path.
Because now I know very little accounting. Even if it is not yet, it has not yet reached my son, I'm in the market there, it helps because I had to add value to myself if I had remained the way I am. And then I also have another colleague, another girl who is working with finance. Because she's trusted in the family relatives, you know, you make your name. Like this bottle is branded, but you can brand yourself. Dan is a thief, Dan is very good, Dan is humble, Dan is active. It's up to you.
I'm not a thief.
Uh-huh. No, you don't even need to talk about, you already, you brand yourself, you don't know how people call you there. But it's you who has created the name. They don't create that name to you. So there is a very trusted cousin of mine. Her colleague went abroad because she's so trusted. She just went around finance. Because she first asked her cousin, what can we all get from UK there at a fair price? And what you can get? Because I don't have any money. So he said that laptops had just come in. She went around finance. I have these laptops, the picture is here. It's so much. Order. But I want you to order with at least half. She went around, she sent the money, they sent her the laptops, paid the balance, she paid the money. So whenever somebody wants a laptop, they approach her. Oh, what capital is that? Just being trusted. Being trusted and fearing God. Because like now, when I tell people, hibiscus city, when you take it, high blood pressure, diabetes, go. Then I go behind, I get a flavor of hibiscus, because the people already trust. Flavor of hibiscus, you put in water, sugar, yeah, it is. You don't see me, but God sees me. There is no way you can progress. Something will happen until it close.
So God cannot be mocked.
You cannot mock God, and God is not stupid. He cannot let you just really work. You have heard people say, I've worked and worked and worked, but you go to those murderers. You park your car there, say, I want 2 kilos of meat. He will give you half kilo of very good meat. Then some fats behind there, some rotten meat he gives you. And he thinks he has got your free money. That's a curse. You have cursed yourself. Tomorrow you find he's not there.
Ms. Prudence, thank you so much for those deep words of wisdom. And with your belief in God, we pray that Bella Wine is indeed going to go international.
Yeah,
we shall
thank
be
you.
Praying for you to achieve.
Somebody has a question there.
I'm called David. I wanted to know the main challenges you faced when you're trying to expand to the outside market. You know, our market is a penetrate in, but when you go to outside market, it it's like broader and harder to and competitive more than what is in ours. So how, what kind of challenges did you face and how did you kind of maneuver?
There is no business life without challenges. Once you don't get those challenges, then you are not going anywhere. I got challenges in Uganda. I overcome them. But still, they are there. But it is the worst. I'm now in East Africa. Beginning of this year, I won an award, 2 awards of East Africa. I'm the best woman entrepreneur in East Africa. There is no... I have the award. There is no woman who has started with no money in her kitchen and has expanded in East Africa. If you know one and the product, show me. There is no woman in East Africa who has made wine from his kitchen to the rented place, to the factory, and to East Africa. Start selling to neighbors, friends, to Uganda, then East Africa. Go to the supermarkets and say, this is the wine from East Africa. So I have those awards. But the challenge is, like, the closest is Rwanda. We cannot even drive from here to Rwanda. Since 2011, I haven't made money. 2011 up to 14, I was doing it informal. You just go by bus, you maneuver, put in the supermarkets, and I'm very lucky. They cannot sell a wine when it doesn't have a seal. But you could find it on a better wine without a seal, and it is moving. But now when I register, they start paying tax, they put seal, the challenges I get. They started telling me you have to pay 70%. Wow. Yet you have already marketed it, you have given people price lists. You can't say I'm increasing. So I'm still doing it on the roads. But if you don't give me more, so I know. But because now... they call, they want my wine. Every expo, I'm there and I do it myself. I talk to each and every... But they're also now beginning to the revenue. You are not supposed to reach revenue. You have to have an agent. Okay. But last time it was just too much. We have come for expo. They told me, Uganda revenue told me, you are going to pay so much. I reached there. I have finished paying, they increase again. Somebody just comes and say, no, this is not enough. You are saying you are selling this bottle at 20,000. Is no. You are lying. It is supposed to be higher than that. They even put intelligence. Somebody calls you, I'm calling from Cavalry. How much is your bottle? So that they know the exact what?
What exact amount you're selling.
Now the expo is for 10 days. 3-4 days you are there waiting for stock. You have paid for space. I stormed revenue. I say, you people, why do you know how much I put in to make this bottle? Why do you have to dictate the price I should be selling it here? And you want me to pay tax according to that price? At first it was, you know, a bit hard, but I told them, you are here because of us. You are seated in this office because of, imagine 3 days you are working on my product and you are going to get salary. Then they started nicknaming me, can't see me because they see her on TV. I said, I don't mind. But since that time, at least that problem is solved. I just go direct. I no longer use it, but I haven't made money from there. But the product is known. So that is a very, very big challenge because they told me, why don't you have the same price like a lady who has the same wine, use the same material, hibiscus? But you, as the price is different. I say, she paid you very well. Where is she? She can't come back. You took all her money. So those challenges are there. You go there and shed tears. They just look at you like this. But I'm not giving up. Yeah, but my last word, you young people, let me bless you, those who have listened to me today. So let me say a simple word, a short prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of life. We thank you so much for this Kafeero TV, the innovation of these young people, continue blessing it. I bless these children. I call them children because they are the ages of my children who have taken their time to come and listen to me and showed much interest. Lord, I wish what I have talked to them, they take it serious, because there is no shortcut. That is the only way you can succeed, and I want them to succeed. Lord, protect them, cover them with your blood so the devils don't come near them to spoil their future. I ask all this through our Son Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.